Hi everyone, welcome to the series of my classes.
Welcome to a new poem, The Ant and the Cricket. It is a fable in poetic form. A fable is a story, often with animals as characters, that convey a moral. Let's start the poem now. A silly young cricket, accustomed to sing through the warm, sunny months of gay summer and spring, began to complain when he found that at home his cupboard was empty and winter was come. Not a crumb to be found on the snow-covered ground. Not a flower could he see, not a leaf on a tree. Oh, what will become, says the cricket, of me? So students, please underline the word silly. Silly means foolish. Accustomed to means used to. Gay means happy. Cupboard means storehouse. Crumb means broken food. Let me explain the first stanza. There was a foolish young cricket, and it used to sing all the time during the warm, sunny months of happy summer and spring. And when it became winter season, it started to complain because its cupboard was empty and he couldn't find even a broken piece of food on the ground. The ground was completely covered with snow. Not a flower he could see and not a leaf on the tree. He couldn't find even a flower or a leaf on the tree. And he was complaining to himself by saying that, oh, what will become of me? At last, by starvation and famine, made bold, all dripping with wet and all trembling with cold, away he set off to a miserly ant to see if, to keep him alive, he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. He wished only to borrow. He would repay it tomorrow. If not, he must die of starvation and sorrow. So, at last, by starvation, underline starvation and write the meaning, suffering or death caused by lack of food. And famine means scarcity of food, otherwise lack of food. So, because of hunger and also lack of food, the cricket became bold. And it was dripping with wet and it was trembling. Trembling in the sense shivering. It was shivering with cold. And finally, he decided to go and meet a miserly ant. Miserly means stingy. So there was a stingy ant to see if, to keep him alive, he would grant him shelter from rain and a mouthful of grain. So the cricket decided to meet the ant in order to ask him a mouthful of grain and also a shelter from the rain. And he wanted to borrow and he didn't want anything for free of cost. He would repay it by the next day. If the ant is not ready to give, definitely the cricket will die out of hunger and also sorrow. Sorrow means sadness. Says the ant to the cricket, I am your servant and friend, but we ants never borrow, we ants never lent. But tell me, dear cricket, did you lay nothing by when the weather was warm? Finally, the cricket went and asked to the ant, and the ant said, we ants never borrow and we ants never lent. But tell me, dear cricket, and he asked the cricket whether he saved anything for the future. Immediately, the cricket said, not I. My heart was so light that I sang day and night, for all nature looked gay. You sang, sir, you sing. Go then, says the ant, and dance winter away. So immediately, the ant got very angry. And finally, he said the cricket to go away from his place and pass the winter by dancing and enjoying. Thus ending, he hastily lifted the wicket. Hastily means hurriedly. Lifted means closed. Wicket means small door. So, after saying all those things, immediately the ant closed the small door and out of the door turned the poor little cricket. After reading this poem, people, fox means people, call this poem as a fable. And the poet will warrant it true. The poet will warrant it true means the poet is also assuring it true. Some crickets have four legs and some have two. The poem is about a cricket who found himself in trouble as the winter season arrived. He found he had nothing to eat, nor had he cared to make a shelter for himself. So he decided to go to an ant for asking help. He wished to borrow some grain from the ant and to spend a day or two in the ant's shelter during the rainy days. His intention was to pay back later on. However, the ant did not help the cricket. The ant told the cricket that it was the rule of ants that they neither borrowed nor lent, and asked the cricket in astonishment if he had saved anything for the future. To which the cricket replied in negative. Moreover, he said that he was so busy enjoying his life during those happy summer and spring seasons, and he did not bother to save anything for the future. On hearing the cricket indulged in dancing, singing, and merrymaking, the ant asked the cricket to try dancing and singing once again during the rough times. Thus, the poem ends with the most significant idea. Some have four legs and some have two. Students, here are some exercises just to go through the video and mark it by yourself. There are match the following, true or false, filling the blanks, and let us discuss the moral of the poem. Always set aside for the rainy day. If we are lazy and if we don't want to work, nobody will help us and we will have to starve. Save today for better tomorrow. Thank you. Have a nice day.